How's everyone? How are you today? Welcome back to Ashi Tang for Kindergarten. Where you learn, I learn, we all learn about the Ashi Tang. And this is Huang. Today, I'm going to go over the homework. And in the meantime, I will also introduce a new coding guideline. But before I start, you probably know by now, what is the first question that I always ask you? You're right. Did you do your homework? If you did, then it's great. When you started, it isn't so hard to keep going. If a job requires effort or unpleasant, do it immediately. The longer you wait, the more difficult it will become. It's like a steam locomotive. It takes a lot of steam to get the wheels moving slowly. Once it starts moving, it gets into the rhythm. It slowly builds speed over time. Soon it up to 60 miles per hour or more. By then, it will run right to almost anything. I hope you get an idea. Alright, without further delay, let's get started. What is the Ashi Tang BCS code for this procedure? Foreign body removal, skin up left thumb. Before we get into how to code this procedure, I want to briefly go over the anatomy and physiology of the skin layers. The top layer of the skin is known as epidermis. This thinner portion of the skin mainly exists to absorb sunlight, water, nutrients, and to protect the deeper layers. The deeper layer and thicker layer of the skin is the dermis. This contains the sweat gland, hair root and follicles, blood vessels, sensory receptor, and other important structure of the integumentary system. Beneath the dermis is the hypodermis or subcutaneous layer. You can see this layer is composed primarily of fatty or adipose tissue and serves as a shock absorber. The fascia is below this layer. Now, it's very, very important that you know where the subcutaneous layer and fascias are. The code from either CBT, IC9, or IC10 will be changed based on the depth of the wound, and it will affect the payment or reimbursement. So please keep that in mind when you read the op report. Now, let's get back to our homework. Clearly, you can tell from this image is that the splinter punctured the top layer of the skin, which is the epidermis. Let's pause the video and open the Ashi Tang BCS table now. If you are new, you don't have the Ashi Tang BCS table. Below this video is the link to where you can download this file. First, this is a medical and surgical procedure, so 0 is the first character. Please go ahead and click on it. This will lead you to the second character, which is the body system. What is the body system of the skin? It's right here. We have skin and press. But do you notice that? We also have the subcutaneous tissue and fascia. That's why it's very, very important that you know the anatomy of the skin layers. In this case, it apparently is skin, so please go ahead and click on the skin and press. This will lead you to the third character, which is the root operation. You already know the objective of this procedure is to remove the foreign body from the thumb, and it's called extirpation. So click on it. This is the right table here, 0SC. What is the body part? Skin of left thumb. But I cannot find a value for the left thumb here. So what are we going to do? Okay, that's the reason I'm going to introduce a new coding guideline. It's coding guideline B4.8, fingers and toes. You don't have to remember this number. I'll just put it up there for your reference. If a body system does not contain a separate body part value for fingers, but she should perform on the fingers as called to the body part value for the hand. Similarly, if a body system does not contain a separate body part value for toes, but she should perform on the toe as called to the body part value for the foot. Basically, what they say is that if there is no value for the thumb, then we can use a value for the hand. In this case, the left hand. So G is the value of the four character. What is the approach? We have only one choice here. So X is the value of the fifth character. There's no device left in place and no qualifier. So what is the final code? 0, H, C, G, X, G, G. How are you doing so far? I hope you got it right. Let's do another quiz together. What is the ICD-10 PCS code for this procedure? Removal of foreign body, subcutaneous tissue, right hand. Unlike the previous case, this case, the nail puncture to the deeper layer of the skin. In this case, it is the subcutaneous tissue. Let's go back to our PCS table. This is the medical and surgical procedure. So 0 is the value of the first character. Please go ahead and click on it. This will lead you to the second character, which is the body system. What is the body system of subcutaneous tissue? We have it here, J. Click on it. This will lead you to the third character, which is the root operation. You already know the objective of this procedure is to remove the foreign body from the subcutaneous tissue and it's called extirpation. So please go ahead and click on it. This will lead you to the fourth character, which is the body part. Where's the right hand here? Okay, it's right here. So I have J is the value of the fourth character for subcutaneous tissue and fascia. What is the approach? It's not a percutaneous. Percutaneous approach requires some kind of image guidance. In this case, open approach. The physician probably make an incision deep into the skin in order to remove the foreign body. And there's no device left in place and no qualifier. So what's the final code? 0, J, C, J, 0, G, G. So how you know so far? I hope you got it right. That's all for now. I hope that you learned something new today. Thank you so much for watching. And don't forget to give me your feedback. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a great day.